Hey guys, Zach here, and welcome back to another action figure review, and today we'll be taking a look at the Bandai Movie Monster series Daimajin. Now, this character actually comes from a trilogy of movies that came out in 1996. All three of the movies in the trilogy were filmed around the same time, but they were all released in like different dates. Of course, this trilogy is known as the Daimajin Trilogy, and the Daimajin Trilogy was produced by Daiei, the same company that produced Gamera. So, Godzilla was, very successful at the time, in, like, the Showa era, like, fairly early on. So, of course, Daiei wanted a piece of that kaiju action. So, of course, they created Gamera, which was pretty successful, but they wanted more, like, tokusatsu-esque, like, kaiju movies. So, they decided to come up with a trilogy of movie known, or, excuse me, a trilogy of movies known as the Daimajin Trilogy. And, essentially, what Daimajin is, he's essentially a statue that gets possessed by the gods to, seek vengeance on the greedy, or the villains in the movie. Or, no, the villains in all three of the movies, I should say. So, yeah, I just watched Daimajin, like, a couple weeks ago, the original trilogy, and I like them a lot. The Daimajin trilogy is great. The first movie, spectacular, love it to death. The second movie, I'll be honest, I don't love it as much. It's still good, but it's not as good as the first movie. And then there's the third movie, which is better, but still, I prefer the first movie. So, yeah, I do really love the Daimajin Trilogy, though. I think they're all good movies, but hands down, the first one is the best. If you do want to watch them, they're on Blu-ray, so you can get them there. They're on Amazon Prime. There are, easy ways to watch the Daimajin Trilogy, so I definitely recommend you go ahead and check those movies out. So, yeah, again, the first movie is my favorite, but like I said, the other two are not bad whatsoever either, so yeah. Anyway, I don't really have a whole lot else to say, so let's just get right into this. Of course, before we take a look at the figure itself, let's take a quick look at the tag here. And the tag here, I mean, it's the same, like, layout as the Gamera Bandai vinyls, or at least the newer ones that are coming out. But we have a screenshot from the first Daimajin movie. Daimajin right here, and Movie Monster Series, the Kadokawa logo. Can you make a new Gamera movie, please? But yeah, on the back here again, we have the movie poster of the original Daimajin, Bandai Namco, and some Japanese that I, for the life of me, can't read. And underneath here, we have Kadokawa, 1966, Bandai, 2002, made in China, and the Bandai logo. And on the inside, we have just a lot more Japanese writing with a picture of Daimajin here. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for the tag there. Now, we'll take a look at the paint. And the painting on this figure, it's not bad. There's not a lot of painting at all, but honestly, the painting that is here does look nice. So let's take a closer look. So, as you can see here, most of the figure is casted in this brownish material, which I think looks good. I think it fits very well. The only parts that are painted are the forearms here and the fists. They're painted a nice bluish color. And going to the face here, again, that is also painted blue. And if we take a look at the eyes here, we can see that they are painted white with black pupils. And yeah, that's pretty much, all the painting on this figure. I guess if I were to add more paint, I guess I'd add, like, dry brushing throughout the figure to give it that, like, old, like, damaged look. But honestly, for what it is, I think the painting on this figure looks nice. Like, the lack of paint apps, like, it's not always a bad thing, as long as it all looks neat. And I think the painting here, or the painting that is here, it looks neat. Nothing looks sloppy, he's not cross-eyed or anything like that, he's looking perfectly straight, and yeah, overall, painting on this figure, like, there's not a lot here, but what is here, it does look nice, and it looks presentable, it's very neat, so yeah, the painting here, it's not bad, it's alright, so the painting, I'd say gets 3/4 of a pass. Now, we'll take a look at the articulation, and there's not a lot here, it's just the arms that move. Be careful with this arm, because this arm, if you do move it 360, does tend to bump into the sword here, so just kind of like flex the material a little bit here, but overall, yeah, that's all there is for articulation on this guy. I mean, depending on how you look at it, some people might find it disappointing. To me, it's totally fine because essentially in the movie, Daimajin is a literal statue, so the lack of articulation here I think is very fitting for the character. I mean, yes, he did like walk around stuff like that, but at the same time, like, this is a Bandai vinyl. This isn't really a Monster Arts-esque figure, so yeah, the lack of articulation, I think is fine. I mean, I guess maybe like a head swivel. Or even like a waist swivel would have been fine too, but honestly, for what it is, like I said, like the lack of articulation, I think is fitting for the character considering that he is indeed a statue. So the articulation here, I'd say gets a pass. Now we'll take a look at the sculpting. And the sculpting on this figure, for the most part, I think the sculpting here looks perfect. I think the sculpting here does a great job capturing the likeness of Daimajin from the movies. There is one thing that I think is a little, like, this is such a minor nitpick, but it's something that I think is worth pointing out. So this is Daimajin from the first movie. You can tell because, the tag here. This is the poster from the first movie. And if you pay attention to Daimajin's head here, you can see that there is a stake, sticking out of his forehead. There was a scene in the movie where, they were destroying the statue before it gets possessed by the gods, and they're trying to destroy it, and they stick a stake in Daimajin's forehead. So through the rest of the movie, when we see Daimajin, he has a stake sticking out of his forehead. As we can see here, there is no stake sticking out of his forehead, so it just looks a little weird. I mean, granted, like, he didn't have a stake sticking out of his head in the second Daimajin movie, but again, this figure is based off of Daimajin from the first Daimajin movie, so a stake sticking out of his forehead I think would have been nice. So maybe like one day we can get like a proper Bandai vinyl of Daimajin with a stake sticking out of his head, or even one based off of the one from Daimajin 3. I think that would look really cool. But yeah, regardless, that is still a very minor nitpick, and overall I do think the sculpting on this figure looks great. So yeah. Sculpting on this figure overall looks great, so the sculpting here, I'd say, gets a pass. Now we'll take a look at the detailing, and the detailing on this figure I think looks very good too, so let's take a closer look. So, starting off with the head here, we can see all the detailing on the helmet here looks great. Very like, very statue-like, very like, stone-esque. I'd like a lot of nice texturing there. I think, yeah, that looks really good. And even the face, I think, is detailed very well. Throughout the body here, the rest of the armor here, again, is just detailed very nicely, very well defined. It looks great. Even his sword here, again, has a lot of really nice detailing here. The stone texturing here just looks great. And yeah, just a lot of really nice detailing throughout. And yeah, that's pretty much it for the detailing on this figure. The detailing here is very nice. I like it a lot. So the detailing on this figure definitely gets a pass. Now we'll do some size comparisons. Here we have the original Bandai Movie Monster Series Gamera, the Showa version. And let me just say, these two actually complement each other very well. I mean, Daimajin is so much shorter than Gamera, so the fact that he's taller here is kind of funny, but regardless, these two complement each other very well, considering that they are both created by Daiei. Here we have the Bandai Movie Monster Series Godzilla 1954, the 65th anniversary version. And unfortunately, I don't have any Ultraman figures. I have yet to watch Ultraman. I really should. I've been kind of slacking on that, but anyway, here we have a kind of non-Godzilla kaiju. Here we have Rodan. This version of Rodan did appear in his own movie before being a part of the Godzilla franchise, so it kind of counts as a non-Godzilla kaiju, kind of, somewhat, sorta. You get the point. Anyway, here they all are. And of course, here we have some hand sanitizer. And here we have Dr. Billy Grant. So at the end of the day, should you get this figure? Honestly, I'd say yes. I do like this figure a lot. I mean, it's very simple. There's not a lot to this figure, but for what it is, I think it's good. Definitely more affordable than other Daimajin figures, or actually, I shouldn't say that. I don't know. I know, Reveltech, I know that's a more like higher end figure line. They made a Daimajin figure that I'm sure is expensive, but this guy is only like 20, 25 bucks, which is honestly not bad at all. So I'd say, if you want this figure, I'd say definitely go for it because, like I said, it's a very simple figure. There's not a lot to it, but for what it is, it's definitely a nice little figure to have, and I do like it. So, yeah. Anyway, that is it for today. Have a great rest of your week, and I will see you in the next video. Peace, Zek out.